O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of Lord appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou branch of Jesse, free your children from all tyranny. From depths of hell your people save, and give them victory over the grave. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, O day spring, come cheer our spirits by your advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night, and death's dark shadow put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel, shall come to thee, O Israel.
The decree went out from the Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. Joseph and Mary travelled from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the town of David called Bethlehem, because Joseph was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. In a year of restrictions and lockdown, where travel has been limited and expectations stifled, let us pray for God's best blessing, the word of life, to be with us this year. Heavenly Father, send the Spirit of your Son Jesus upon us this Christmas. May he, the word of life, guide us on our way.
Singing excellent. And what's brought me hope this year is the support and the love of my family and my household.
My favourite thing about Christmas is the spirit of putting up the Christmas tree, decorating the house and listening to Christmas carols.
What gives me hope? The goodness, kindness and patience of everyone as we try to figure out how to get together, be with our families and be with each other for Christmas.
Hi, I would like to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas and a joyful season and a Happy New Year, and hopefully 2021 will be a lot better for all of us and we can spend it with our families and loved ones.
Hi, my name is Meleana Fifita. This year has been tough for everyone, but my family, my faith and my community has brought me hope. Awhake mamaho hakilisi masifiafia, awhātu.
Silent.
what a thy birth, Jesus, Lord, a thy birth.
Welcome to our Jesus is Christmas special. We have gathered together some really wonderful artists from all around Melbourne to help bring some Christmas joy. It goes without saying that it's been a particularly challenging year this year. So our hope is that tonight we can come together, sing some of our favourite Christmas carols, and also raise some much needed funds for the Catholic Care Giving Tree appeal. I'll be back with some more information on how you can do that. But in the meantime, our narrator, Jo Doolin, will lead us in the Christmas story. We hope you enjoy Jesus is Christmas.
Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place this way. Mary was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public shame, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he'd resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son. You are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel." So Joseph woke up. He did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. Mary gave birth to a son, and they gave him the name Jesus. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. Jesus is a light in the darkness. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Let us pray that God will open our hearts this Christmas. Help us, Lord Jesus, not to be afraid of what God asks of us. Open our hearts and help us to trust in your love and mercy, for you are Emmanuel, God with us.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Saviour's birth. Long lay the world in sin and
That was Larissa Cairns, one of our regular cantors here at St. Patrick's Cathedral. We also took our cameras out into the parishes to capture some more carols and to hear a little more of people's hopes for Christmas.
At Christmas time, I love putting up the tree and listening to Bing Crosby's White Christmas. And I love having a beautiful lunch with my family.
So I suppose for me, as we take this moment to stop and to reflect on the coming of God amongst us as one of us, I think what gives me hope is that God meets us in our humanity, in the ordinariness and the ups and downs of our everyday life.
What brings me hope during this crisis is the hope that I see in the gardens. I spend a lot of time in the gardens. I see the bulbs die down. I see them come again. I see the seeds that have been in the ground and the rain that we've had bring the flowers up and the veggies up.
Christmas to us is a time of celebration, not only the birth of Jesus, but families get together, especially this year. It's very important that after so many months of lockdown, we're finally here today, and this is our first time in the church since April, I think. So we're very grateful to be here. Kia ki motor ko toa katonga, o ko ate mau popo aki I Talamanu ke Christmasi, me komunio sunshine, o fa ke mouma o Christmasi e fia, ma tau fo monu ia ma ofa malopito.
Hello friends. Christmas celebrations in the city of Bethlehem are likely to be really quiet this year. Under the weight of the global pandemic and the ongoing troubles in the Middle East, that special destination for so many thousands of pilgrims will resemble something more akin to that familiar Christmas carol, O Little Town of Bethlehem, which says, "How still we see thee lie." Perhaps it was a stillness that met the Holy Family more than 2,000 years ago as they sought a place of safety to welcome the birth of their child. Doors had been shut to them amidst their own time of worrying restrictions. how familiar this aspect of the Nativity story to our lives this year. Jesus was born in such a time as this, and in fact, is born for such a time as this. He comes to us always in our need and our reality. There is much said about what a COVID Christmas will be like, but is this really the question we need to be asking at this time? This year has certainly been challenging in ways that have been unimaginable, but has turned our lives from moments of discomfort and insecurity. And whilst we have sought creative ways to engage in our worship and in our connections with one another, it's never been about us reinventing something. Christmas too is not of our making. The tinsel and gifts, the food and holidays certainly play a part in how we acknowledge Christmas, but they are not Christmas. Jesus is Christmas. Then, now and always. Whether it's into a peaceful landscape or a worn-torn one, a time of uncertainty and isolation or one of abundant friendship and family, whether it's in poverty or in plenty, the question we should ask is, what is the kind of Christmas we want to live? Isn't it one that holds close to the promise of life and hope that the birth of Jesus gives to all of us? And in that very gift, is not our calling to bring this life and hope into the lives of others? Jesus is the gift beyond all gifts which we receive, and he is the gift we can then always give. Which brings me to another part of that carol. Yet in thy dark streets shineth the everlasting light, the hopes and fears of all. The years are met in thee tonight. When you gather this Christmas, in whatever way it is, don't labour on the darkness and on this year past. Recall instead the wonder of that birth and the light by which we can now see ahead. Jesus is our Christmas. And happy Christmas to you all.
Not far away from the Bethlehem stable, there were shepherds keeping watch over their flock by night. All of a sudden, an angel of the Lord appeared before them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them. The shepherds were terrified. However, the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born for you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This is a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, the sky was filled with a great company of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favour rests." Like the shepherds, we are also asked to respond to the call of the angel, to come and see the Saviour, the Messiah, Christ the Lord. Jesus Christ, infant King of the universe, you saved humanity by becoming one of us. May we welcome you into our lives and families, into our homes and our troubled world.
Thank you.
the Sunshine Parish Tongan Choir. Now, of course, Christmas in Melbourne isn't really Christmas without Silvie Paladino, and we're so thankful that she agreed to come in and help us out. So here is Silvie with a Christmas classic.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing of the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains.
Christmas means to me spending time with family and friends, carols on Christmas Eve, going to Mass together on Christmas morning, big family lunch, and then catching up with family and friends around the world on video chat. So wishing everybody a very happy Christmas, Nollag Hanna Dich in Irish, and have a wonderful Christmas and a happy new year.
Christmas is always the best time of the year, but this time it's different way because of this COVID. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year.
The thing I enjoy about Christmas is it's a time for the community to come together and celebrate our common faith in Jesus.
In these difficult times, I'm really looking forward to spending Christmas with my family. Hopefully with the easing of restrictions, we'll be able to get together because I have a very large family. So maybe we have to meet in a park, but that'll be okay. It'll be just a lovely, joyful time to be all together.
Hi guys, my name is Florence, and Christmas means to me spending time with our family. It's not about the presents, but it's also a reminder of our birth, Jesus Christ. Merry Christmas and have a Happy New Year.
Thank you.
come, they told me, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. A newborn king to see, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. I'll find its gifts we bring, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. Too late before the king, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum. So to honor him, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, when we come. I am a poor boy to pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. I have no gift to bring, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. That's fit to give a king, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum. Shall I play for you, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, on my drum?
I played my drum for him, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. I played my best for him, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum.
Smiled at me, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, made my drum.
Oh, yeah.
After Jesus was born, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is this child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and we've come to worship him." He called together all the chief priests and teachers of the law and asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they responded. Then Herod called the wise men and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." So the wise men went on their way, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, guiding them until it stopped over the place where Jesus lay. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another way. After the wise men found and worshipped the Christ child, they changed. They travelled a different road. God wants our worship at Christmas, but also wants us to change and live a life of service. Lord Jesus Christ, may we worship you at the end of this difficult year. Help us to embrace the real work of Christmas, to find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, and bring peace to the world.
Bearing gifts, we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of one, star of mine, star with royal beauty bright, west of leading, sin proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Oh, but a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign. Oh, star of one, the star of mine, star with royal beauty bright, west of leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume breathes a life of gathering gloom, sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying. Seated in the cold tomb. Oh, star of one, star of might, star with royal beauty bright, west or leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Guide us to light, perfect light. Oh.
Welcome back. We hope you're enjoying the Jesus is Christmas special. Now don't forget that the Catholic Care Giving Tree appeal really needs your help to make Christmas a little brighter for struggling families. And you can visit the website to make a donation.
Mild, God and sinners reckon.
joyful holy nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord. Late in time, behold him comes, offspring of a virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the God.
Christmas is, I love food and just being around family, and Merry Christmas.
Hi everyone, my name's Michael Petruccelli and I would just like to wish you a Merry Christmas. It's been quite a year, a very difficult year, and with all the restrictions loosening, it's wonderful that we are now able to get to see family. And for me, family is an extremely important part of my life.
My name is Denise. And my hope for 2020 would be for Christmas, and that all would enjoy a family Christmas after all the restrictions we've been through, and a blessed one.
Merry Christmas and Ofato.
My favourite part of Christmas is being with family. Merry Christmas, everyone.
G'day, my name is Peter Nguyen, a 4-year seminarian. When I've been asked what a Christmas means to me, so I just thinking about when I was in Vietnam, it is the time for the gathering with my family and friends.
Hi everyone, my name is Emeline Fifita, and Christmas means the patience of Jesus' birth and the love of everyone flowing around. Merry Christmas!
Falls and fields of all the years.
Amidst the anxieties of 2020, there has also been innovation and learnings. We have become more adept and creative in using technology for teaching, simulation, ministry, and business, finding alternate ways to best support students. For example, a staff giving program matched by ACU. Even the way we think about space has changed. Do we need big lecture theatres? Do we need to travel for meetings? What does flexible work look like? Our staff have been outstanding in their commitment to support our students through this period, and we are all looking forward to a healthier and safer 2021. On behalf of the Australian Catholic University, our Victorian campuses in Fitzroy and Ballarat, and our Vice-Chancellor, Professor Greg Craven, I wish you a peaceful and holy Christmas.
Throughout the year, in our hospitals, in our aged care homes, in clients' homes, and in all of the other care settings we work, our people have worked tirelessly to keep those they care for safe. They've come to work selflessly to help others and to work in some extraordinarily difficult circumstances to help us through this difficult year. It has not been without challenge and nor without sacrifice, and it certainly has elicited a range of emotions from us all. But what has shone through is their unwavering commitment to give life to this healing ministry of Christ. As Pope Francis said, we are all of us in this boat. And as we have heard from all parts of the global community, we are in this together. Our shared humanity and the need to care has never been more evident than in 2020. I hope you enjoy being together over the Christmas season with those you love, and I wish you again a very happy Christmas.
The greatest challenge for Villa Maria Catholic Homes this year has been keeping our community connected. We've had to close services, stand down staff, and put restrictions in place. Our staff have gone to extraordinary lengths, working long hours, using technology, even becoming hairdressers. Our hope and spirit has been kept alive by the appreciation shown by our amazing community. I'm extremely proud of everyone at Villa Maria Catholic Homes. The sacredness of everyone's life has been at the centre of our decision making. I'd like to wish you all a very happy Christmas.
Hello, my name is Larissa Cairns and I'm one of the cantors here at the Cathedral. This has been a challenging year for so many people, and one of the greatest challenges I faced was homeschooling my six-year-old. But one of the greatest blessings in amidst all that was seeing him learn how to read. Hope you all have a great Christmas.
Christmas to me is a great opportunity to reflect and prepare for the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God. And it's a great opportunity for the family to get together and build our faith.
Hi, we're the Sully Family.
Merry Christmas, everyone, and a Happy New Year.
Yay!
Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We hope you've loved this Jesus is Christmas special. And don't forget that you can help needy families this Christmas through the Catholic Care Giving Tree Appeal. God bless, and we hope you have a joyful Christmas.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy.
sounding joy.